Hey guys, what's up? Shadowlands back with another episode of Theory of Everything. As I promised, I have a lot of these episodes coming out this week, so that's something for you guys to look forward to, I hope. I haven't done this in a while, and I know it has a pretty big fan base as far as my series goes, so I hope this one is going to make a lot of people happy. I'm coming back today with Theory of Evolution. Now, I realize this is a highly controversial topic. It really overlaps a lot with science and religion, and because I have a very multiracial community as viewers and an audience, everyone's going to have their own take on this, and honestly, this is just my take. As a lot of you guys know, religiously, I'm a Christian, so I'm going to be using examples, but it really can apply to a lot of different religions as well, and science is pretty much overarching as all of them, but this is basically a really controversial topic, because it's either you have your extremists who don't believe in theory of evolution at all, or you have people that think it overlaps, and I'm one of those people that think it kind of overlaps with religion and science, so that's why I'm going to go into this in kind of a multi-viewpoint sort of way. So basically, all creatures, and this is from science's point of view, have evolved to some degree, to some extent. And that sort of encompasses humans as well, but we come a little bit later. So evolution is the process of perfection. I don't think anyone's going to argue with that. The whole purpose of evolution is to adapt to an environment, to evaluate changes in an environment, and change yourself, change your genetics based on that. It's literally on a baseline, the most extreme version, survival of the fittest. It's basically an easy way to explain an extremist idea. Survival of the fittest, Darwin's theory, all that stuff. So now, if you want to look at the tree that I have mapped out, I basically have it where you have, like, monkeys, which kind of evolved into Neanderthals, which evolved into more Neanderthals and sort of died off because they didn't really last that long. They didn't have the mental capacity that humans have. And that's one thing that is usually more of a religious-based topic, where Neanderthals and humans were very, very different. And I do believe on that, although I see them more as cousins, almost. So the difference between... I have Adam and Eve written there, but that's just because of the Christianity, first human sort of thing. This really applies to almost any religion. Whatever your beliefs are of the first people, just kind of insert that right there. Very first humans, I just used Adam and Eve as an example. The difference between like them and the Neanderthals were a consciousness of... or self-awareness, if you want to put it that way. So being self-conscious is just another way to say self-aware. And those first humans evolved into the rest of us humans, and they probably looked relatively different than we do now. Although they were also probably, you know, different from Neanderthals as well. Although they were sort of cousins, you could almost say they were different from Neanderthals. And obviously, over the past several thousand years, you can't think that they would look exactly the same as us now. So there's probably some variation there. Although the general body shape was probably the same. So then there's humans, yay, and then everyone else, and then give, like, what, 2,000 years, give or take 10,000, you have us. So, yeah, there's that whole thing there. So we've evolved, but not directly from monkeys, obviously. I think there was some sort of gap in between monkeys and the first humans that are really considered human. So I think there's a pretty big gap there, and that's where a lot of the fuzzy area is that causes all this controversy. And I really don't want to speak to that myself because I don't have a very clear understanding of that, but to be fair, I don't think anyone really does. Yeah, you can always argue with science, but then there's that whole religion thing, and I think it does overlap in certain areas, and the further we go along both of those routes of science and religion, the more it's going to start overlapping to a point where science and religion are really going to become the same thing. Now, I'm not really going into that whole Scientology thing, because I'm not one of those kind of people, but still, just thought I'd bring that up. So, really, Neanderthals are the closest to the original humans, but they died off thousands of years ago, so, like, yeah, humans won, Neanderthals zero, humans win, yay. So that's really just kind of my whole very baseline description of theory of evolution. So if you guys are interested more on this topic, I'd be happy to go over it with you guys in like a private message or something. But I do fully realize that the comment section is going to have a lot of controversy in it. That's just because it's going to be a big thing and I have a very multiracial audience and I really appreciate that because it gives us a lot of different takes. But everyone's going to have their own opinions and I ask you guys to respect those kind of things. So thank you for watching. Please rate, comment, subscribe, drop a like, check out the Facebook group, and I will see you guys in the next video. Shadowlands out.